Hello, cleaning business owners. I am Debbie Sardone, and I am so honored that I get to talk with you today about profit explosion secrets, how to get more profits now without spending a dime. Now, I will be referring to my notes right here on my computer, so bear with me. I have a lot of information to share in a short amount of time, and I don't want to miss a single bullet point. So bear with me as I read some of my bullet points. So today I'm going to share three rules for exploding profits so you can make more money and live better. Isn't that what owning your own business is all about? It's not just about making money. It's about making more money and living better. Entrepreneurs truly started most of their businesses to create a lifestyle and freedom that they couldn't get working for somebody else. So it's not just about making more profit. It's also about living better and being able to live the life that you always dreamed you would have when you started your own business. A couple of books I'm going to recommend to you. First and foremost, this is an old one. I really like this. It's Profits Aren't Everything. They're the Only Thing. It's kind of a play on words. And it's by George Coutier. I'm not sure I say that right. It's a great book. I read this book many, many years ago. You'll love it. It'll help you put profit first. And then, of course, something that's a little bit newer, even though I've been teaching this concept forever, but in the last few years, the book by Mike Malkowitz, Profit First, has emerged as a bestseller, and you will absolutely love this book. I encourage you to go get those two books and read them. It will help put you on the path to putting your profits first and realizing the kind of income and profit that you deserve for all the hard work you put into running a cleaning business. And trust me, I know. I started cleaning houses like most of you out of the trunk of my car. In fact, I started back in 1984 just cleaning houses for some extra money. And of course, back then, I was 100% profitable, right? Or probably 98% profitable because I was doing all the work myself. My business quickly grew beyond my ability to do all the cleaning, so I started hiring staff, which is a lot. Oftentimes, what a lot of you have done is your business grew beyond your ability to say yes to all the work that's coming in, so you just start hiring staff, and that's what I did. And of course, that's when things began to fall apart. I didn't have a plan. My growth was chaotic, and it was definitely unprofitable. I remember when my own profit was such a mess that at times, at the end of the month, after working like a dog, you know, 50, 60, 70, 80 hours a week, at times there was nothing left over to pay me. By the time I paid all my bills and all my workers and all the payroll taxes and the overhead, at times there was nothing left over for me. And at the lowest point in my business, I was so unprofitable, I had accrued over $80,000 in credit card debt. I did not know what I was going to do. I was terrified. I was going to have to close my doors and go bankrupt. I was at my wit's end. I was so unhappy. My business was a chaotic mess. Oh, it was growing, but it was a chaotic mess. In fact, at that time, it was over $600,000. But I was working too long for not enough. My employees were walking all over me. I couldn't fire anybody because I didn't have anybody to take their place. And I remember I'd go to bed every single night, sick to my stomach, worried. I knew I was sitting on a gold mine, but I didn't know how to make it work. I didn't know how to mine the gold. And I was confident that I had what it takes to be a successful person. I just knew I did not have the steps. I didn't know what I was doing wrong. I didn't know what I was doing right, and so I didn't know what to change and what to keep doing and what to keep doing more of. And I struggled intensely for about 15 years. Eventually, through a series of events, I hired a team of business consultants out of Chicago, Illinois. Now, that company charged me $40,000, and this was back before webinars and online coaches and Zoom and all of this. None of us were using the internet really for business back then. And that's what it cost. And they flew a team of their consultants out to my business in Texas. And again, this was like more than 25 years ago, and it cost me $40,000. But together we created a business formula and a business model for profitability, for employee attraction and retention that is second to none. And I've been following this ever since. 9 months after hiring them, 9 months after saying yes to myself, when I did not have the money, I couldn't afford $40,000. But I said yes. And I don't know how I paid that off. It took us years. And I don't know how I said yes to myself. But instead of making excuses, I found a way. And I said yes. And 9 months after hiring them, my business was grossing $1 million a year, and we have ever since. So we've grossed over $25-30 million over the last 25 years. Now, fast forward to today. We ended last year, 2019, our business did $1.8 million in revenue, and we are on track to end 2020 at $2 million in revenue. We have 45 employees, six are on my admin team. And because of the profit model and the model that I learned from that consulting business, I built a scalable, profitable business, which meant I could afford to hire my administrative team and high-level people to work for me to run my business. So now I have a self-running business, and I've been retired for more than a dozen years, probably close to 14 years now. I've been retired. I literally have a self-running business. It runs itself. It runs by the numbers. And so now I have the income and the freedom to do what I want and to use my time the way I truly want. And I get to train business owners all over the world. In fact, my residential cleaning business academy, CBF, is number one in the world. We've created more mop-free millionaires than anyone on the planet. And now I'm certifying CBF coaches to teach my formula to others. The freedom and the income I was able to create from a successful cleaning business allowed me to launch my nonprofit, Cleaning for a Reason. And we've been able to help over 50,000 families who are battling cancer get their home cleaned for free. And like I said, I get to help business owners like you all over the world finally create a business that works, that creates the income and the freedom that they deserve. And so I have to ask you before we delve into profits and how to create explosive profits, what would you do if you improved your profits and you began to create freedom in your business? If your business began to work for you instead of you working for it, what would you do? Would you start a nonprofit? Would you volunteer more? Would you, go into the mission field? Would you write a book? Would you start speaking and training? Would you use your time to help others, volunteer at your favorite charity, or start your own charity? What would you do if you could make your business work, if you could create the profits that you deserve? And I think that's an important question to ask, because that will fuel your inspiration and motivation to make the changes. So there's three rules that I want to share with you today from our profit model. Obviously, there's a lot more pieces to this puzzle, but there are three top rules around profitability that I'm going to share with you today. Number one, plan your profit. Number two, know your numbers. And number three, charge what you're worth. So rule number one, plan your profit. This is how you put profit first. I've been saying this forever. If profit doesn't come first, it doesn't usually come last. It just doesn't come at all. You have to plan your profit first. And even before the book, Profit First, I've been saying, if you don't have a profit plan, then in all likelihood, you won't have much profit at all. You might have some, but in most cases, it will be disappointing. So the first question I want to ask you, and you need to look in the mirror and ask yourself, is what's your profit plan? Now, I recommend that you engineer backwards what you want. I am a firm believer that just about everything in business, if you will just engineer it backwards, you'll be able to find the answer. So do you have a profit model? And what does it look like if you do? If you don't, then you're just relying on the wishing and hoping method at the end of the month. And that's not a good guarantee for success. So now everybody follows a different model. So I can't give you just a blanket example of what your profit model should look like. I can only give you an example of what the CBF profit model looks like. Because everybody does different, your profit model will be different. But I just want to give you as an example. So in the CBF profit model plan, number one, our model assumes a planned owner's income and profit of somewhere between $10,000 and $12,000 a year, owner's income and profit for each full-time house cleaner working for you. It's that specific and it's that simple. And nothing is easy. I'm certainly not going to imply running your own business is easy, but the concepts must be simple or you'll never be able to achieve them. And it's that simple. So that's just an example. In our planned owner's income and profit, our model assumes $10,000 to $12,000 a year owner's income and profit for each full-time cleaner working for you. So what does that look like in practical terms? So on the low end, for the owner who doesn't clean, now this model does not assume the owner is cleaning, of course, for the owner who does not clean. So you're running the business, you're not cleaning the accounts. If you had five full-time employees, then following this specific profit model, your personal income should be right around $50,000 to $60,000 a year, right? That's your income. That's what's left over to pay you income and profit. If you had 8 to 10 full-time cleaners working for you following this specific profit model, your income should be somewhere between $80,000 and $100,000 a year, owner's income and profit. So that's just an example of a very simple profit model. What is yours? Do you know what it is? If you don't, work on finding out what is it now and how can you improve it if it's not satisfactory. So next, you have to have a planned overhead expense model to support the profit model. So it's just a pipe dream to say, well, I want 25% of everything I gross in revenue without a planned overhead model, right? So if you don't plan your overhead, meaning if you don't plan your expenses, then you won't have a model that supports the profit you hope to achieve. So the next thing you have to do is have a planned overhead expense model to support that profit model. And we have a very exact and specific overhead model. So what I teach is you build all of your expenses around your planned profit model. In other words, until you can afford it inside of your overhead budget, you don't buy it. You don't add those expenses. You plan your overhead budget and you live and die within it. So planned profit is the only way to guarantee you have profit. And the only way you will be able to plan your profit is if you plan your expenses, right? Because expenses are extremely easy to grow out of control. So you develop your profit model, you live and buy that plan, and you control and monitor those expenses every single month obsessively. So for example, if you want 20% profit as an owner, and you are spending 55% on employee wages, cost of goods sold, direct labor, then that leaves you 25% overhead budget, right? So that's everything else, like the lights and the water and the rent, and if you buy cars and cleaning supplies and general liability and software subscriptions, everything. And so that leaves you like 25% in the middle, if that's your model, if that's your model. But what I'm saying is that overhead budget has to be controlled, it has to be monitored, and you have to know what it should be. And in our case, our planned overhead budget is right around 25% of revenue. That's our plan. That doesn't fit everybody's model. You have to follow a specific model for that to even be achievable. But whatever model you're following, I guarantee you, you have an overhead budget that is consistent, and you need to control it. You have to monitor it, and you have to monitor it obsessively or it will get out of control. And then rule number two, run your business by the numbers. If you don't know your numbers, you don't know your business. I talk to business owners every single day. I talk to hundreds of people every single year. They don't know their numbers. What percentage are you spending of your revenue on labor? I'm not sure. What about on overhead? I'm not sure. What percentage of your revenue are you able to create as owner's income and profit? I don't know. You have to know your numbers. If you don't know your numbers, you don't know your business. I've been an absentee owner now for, like I said, 14 years. If I did not know my numbers, I can almost guarantee you my numbers would be in decline instead of increasing. 100% of high achievers know their numbers. Please write that down. Hang it on the wall so you see it every single day. 100% of high achievers know their numbers, period. If you want to be a high achiever, you have to know your numbers. Income and profits are the only true measure of the health of your business. I don't care how much you make. All that matters is how much do you keep. If you don't know your numbers, you don't know how much you make, you don't know how much you keep, you don't know what's costing you where. and you have to know those numbers. And honestly, there's probably only six or seven numbers you really need to pay close attention to. It's not like it's 100 numbers. It's not complicated. It's actually quite simple. What's difficult is just the discipline to pay attention every month. Just the discipline, not the numbers themselves. So if you don't know your numbers, you don't know your business, period. You are literally winging it. Do the math every month. The math doesn't lie. What you pay attention to improves. Write that down. Stick that on your wall. What you pay attention to improves. If you're doing the math and paying attention every single month, you will improve them. So here's a few practical things you can pay attention to. First of all, or practical steps you can follow. First of all, run a profit and loss statement every single week until you understand exactly where you are. Once you do, then you can run the profit and loss statement once a month forever. And there's no excuse for letting 2, 3, 4, 5 months go by where you have not printed off or pulled up and analyzed your profit and loss statement every single month. What you pay attention to, you will control, you will improve. So you pay attention to the numbers every single month. As an absentee owner, I look at my profit and loss statement every single month for the last 14 years. And if I see a number slipping, I can jump on it immediately and find out what's going on. Why is this number climbing? Why is this expense growing out of control? So here's four things you'll pay attention to on your profit and loss statement, right? So four things. Number one, obviously, the revenue, right? What were the sales we made last month? You always want to pay attention to that. You should know month over month over month, what are your revenues each month? You shouldn't have to call your CPA to ask. But then these other three numbers are critical. What is your direct labor cost every single month? What is that direct labor cost every single month? And what is it as a percentage of the revenue? It's critical. Is your direct, and when I say direct labor, that's just the wages that you pay to the people who clean, not the administrative wages. That's under overhead. The wages that you pay to the people who clean, that's your direct labor cost. QuickBooks calls it cost of goods sold. And include your payroll burden, so your workers' comp and your federal taxes. So what is that number as a percentage every single month of your revenue? Is it 55%? Is it 60%? Is it 65%? Is it 70%? Is it 35%? What is that number? Pay attention to it every single month, your direct labor costs. The second number to pay attention to every single month is your overhead expense. This is all other bills except for the wages to clean the houses. This is all your other bills. If you're buying cars, if you're wrapping them, if you have computer subscription fees, all your marketing, your general liability, your cleaning supplies, the stuff people break that you have to pay for, your rent, your utilities, everything except for your owner's income, that's your overhead. What is that number every single month? Are you monitoring it? And what is that number as a percentage of revenue? Is it consistently 25% or 30% or 35% or 22%? What is that number? Pay attention every single month. And then number four, of course, the owner's income and profit every single month. How much is left over for you? Owner's income and profit. How much? I don't care. Income is taken as a paycheck. Profit is taken as distribution. I don't care how you take it. What is that number as a percentage of revenue consistently every month? Is it 15%? Is it 10%? Is it 20%? 22%? 12%? What is it? Pay attention. It shouldn't be going up and down wildly every month. Pay attention. What you pay attention to, you can improve. So pay attention to the percentages of those three things of the revenue every single month. And then lastly, rule number three, this one's pretty simple. Be a fanatic about charging what you're worth. You cannot make a profit if you continually undercharge. I will tell you that in the 14 years I've been doing consulting, probably 90 to 95% of the people I talk to believe they're charging as much as they possibly can in their area. And 95% of them are undercharging for their market by anywhere from 20 to 25 to 30%. Consistently, people think they're charging at the max of what they can charge, and consistently they are undercharging by 25 and 30%. So what can you do about making sure you charge what you're worth? Because this is one of the top issues in lack of profits. First of all, you have to do a market survey annually at a minimum. And during really crazy times of the economy, like high growth or recession, you need to maybe do a market survey twice a year. But at a minimum, you need to do a market survey once a year of the professional cleaning services in your area and find out what they're charging in terms of their per billable hour rate. It's always best to shop the professional franchises because they tend to stay on top of pricing. And so do a market survey no less than once a year. Also, you need to raise your prices when you find out you are undercharging. That's critical for all new business coming in. And then thirdly, you need to bring your legacy clients up to market value. So many people have clients on their books that they've been servicing 3, 4, 5, 8, 10 years without a price increase. That's a huge mistake and it's killing your profitability. You have to raise the prices of your legacy clients. And then once you've raised the prices of your legacy clients, you've raised the prices you're charging on new clients coming in, you have to stay on top of it every single year. Otherwise, you do all this work, a year goes by, 2 years go by, 3 years go by, and now your rates are outdated again. You have to raise your prices every single year. And if you do this in small increments, nobody's going to fire you. It's when you have to make a giant leap in a rate increase that people get mad and frustrated and fire your service. So do those rate increases annually. Bring your legacy clients up, keep your current inbound new clients at market value, and constantly do market surveys at least once a year to make sure you know that you are charging what you're worth. Okay, so you have taken the first step to getting more profits without spending a dime. And learning to pay attention to your business, learning the numbers to plan your profit and to raise your prices. So most of the people that are running a cleaning business, I would say over 90% are not satisfied with their profits. They feel like they work too many hours for too low of a pay. So what I've done was I've created a 10-day challenge that I'm going to invite you to. And this challenge is called the Profit Explosion Challenge. And I'm going to invite you to come to my 10-day challenge. It's really fun and very simple. For 10 days straight, I'm going to be sharing with you profit explosion secrets to help you fix and improve your profits permanently. Not just put a temporary fix on it, but to fix and improve your profits permanently. And it's really simple and it's quite fun. I keep it simple and I keep it fun. And it for 10 days, you will have me coaching you with some next step strategies to improve your profit. So join me for my 10-day profit explosion challenge. And if you use promo code ZenMaid, you'll get in for just $1. So I hope you'll join me. Use the promo code ZenMaid, get into our 10-day challenge for $1. And we're also going to launch a private Facebook group just for our 10-day challenge profit explosion members. So you'll have a place to kind of share your homework, ask your questions. I will be in that group helping you every step of the way, going live every single day for 10 days to help you. And so we'll have our private Facebook group. You'll have all the information, some worksheets to download to help you with your profits, and you'll absolutely love it. And the best part is you get it in for $1. So I want you to go and register now while you're thinking about it at cleaningbusinessprofitsecrets.com. cleaningbusinessprofitsecrets.com. If you use ZenMaid as your promo code, you get in for $1. So cleaningbusinessprofitsecrets.com. I hope to see you there, and I can't wait to help you explode your profits so you can make more and you can live better. So let me just recap the three rules that I share with you today. Plan your profit, know your numbers, charge what you're worth. Hope to see you in the 10-day challenge.